क्वेश्चन नंबर 61, टेस्ट थ्री पार्ट टू, क्वेश्चन नंबर 61. वी हैव टू अरेंज द फॉलोइंग ऑर्बिटल्स इन द ऑर्डर ऑफ स्क्रीनिंग इफेक्ट. एज वी नो दैट एस ऑर्बिटल इज क्लोजेस्ट टू द न्यूक्लियस एंड एफ ऑर्बिटल इज फार्देस्ट फ्रॉम द न्यूक्लियस. If orbital is more closer to the nucleus, more shielding effect. So stronger shielding effect. If orbital is far from the nucleus, then poor shielding effect. So according to this, S orbital has stronger shielding effect. After that, P orbital, then D orbital, and F orbital has poor shielding effect. So correct order, question number 61, option A is correct. Now question number 62. In question number 62, as we know that electron gain enthalpy is proportional to ease of electron addition. Group 16 and group 17 elements are given. Group 16 elements oxygen and sulfur are given, and group 17 fluorine and chlorine are given. As we know that valence electron group 16 are 6, while valence electron in group 17 are 7. So in both oxygen sulfur there are 6 valence electron, and in both fluorine and chlorine there are 7 valence electron. But oxygen belong to second period and fluorine also belong to second period, while chlorine belong to third period and sulfur also belong to third period. When electron is added to oxygen atom as compared to sulfur atom, electron will suffer more repulsion as valence electron are in second period, second shell. So there are six electrons. So incoming electron will suffer more repulsion in oxygen atom as compared to sulfur addition. So in case of sulfur, addition of electron is easy. If ease of electron addition, then electron gain enthalpy is more. So in group 16, electron gain enthalpy of sulfur is more than oxygen. Similarly, in case of group 17, electron gain enthalpy of chlorine is more than fluorine. And we know that electron gain enthalpy increases across the period. So group 17 electron gain enthalpy is more than group number 16 electron gain enthalpy. So first we arrange group 17. Chlorine has more electron affinity than fluorine, and then sulfur has more electron gain enthalpy than oxygen atom. So question number 62, option number B is correct. Now question number 63, similar to question number 62. Question number 63 is, the electron affinity of halogen are given. Fluorine is 322 and chlorine is 349. The question is, the higher value of Cl as compared to fluorine is due to why? As we know that fluorine is second period element and chlorine is third period element. So ease of electron addition in case of chlorine, because in chlorine atom the incoming electron will suffer less repulsion. So option number A is correct. Weaker electron-electron repulsion in chlorine than fluorine. So due to weaker electron-electron repulsion in chlorine, addition of electron is easy in case of chlorine atom, and ease of electron addition is proportional to electron gain enthalpy. So question number 63, option A is correct. Due to weaker electron-electron repulsion in Cl. Question number 63, option A is correct. Now question number 64. In question number 64, which of the following option in the order of arrangement does not agree with the variation of property? So we have to find which option is against the variation of property. First option is for ionization enthalpy. As we know that period two elements, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, ionization energy order given this, but we know that electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3 and oxygen 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. As we know that electronic configuration of nitrogen atom is more than oxygen atom, so ionization energy of nitrogen must be more than oxygen atom. So correct option must be boron then carbon. So this option is wrong. Correct option should be boron, carbon and then oxygen and then nitrogen. So first property is against the variation. Now second, option number second. In option number second, electron gain enthalpy order is given I, Br, Cl and then F. As we know that electron gain enthalpy of chlorine is more than fluorine due to weaker electron-electron repulsion in chlorine atom. So second property is also against the variation. So question number 64, both option A and option B, both are correct. Now question number 65. Question number 65. In question number 65, which of the following compound does the central atom follow the octet rule? Follow the octet rule. It means central atom contains 8 electrons. So option A is SCl2. We know sulfur is group number 16 element. So valence electron are 6. Valence electron are 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Chlorine atom contains 7 electrons. So octet of chlorine is complete. Chlorine atom 7 electrons. So octet of chlorine is complete. And in question, central atom has complete octet. So here sulfur also has complete octet as there are 8 electrons. So in SCl2, octet of central atom sulfur is complete. So question number 65, option number A is correct. Now question number 66. In question number 66, question is, in the Lewis dot structure, the electron which complete an octet but are not located between the two atoms are referred to. For example, question number 66, we take example of HF, fluorine, hydrogen fluoride. As hydrogen has 1 electron and fluorine has 7 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So hydrogen will complete the duplet and fluorine will complete the octet. So there is formation of bond between the hydrogen and fluorine and 6 electrons are not a part of bonding. Only one electron is a part of bonding. So this is known as bond pair electron. While those electrons which are not a part of bonding are known as lone pair of electrons. Are known as lone pair of electrons in Lewis dot structure. So question number 66, option number A is correct. Option A is correct. Now question number 67. In question number 67. In question number 67, in which of the following set do all the compounds contain ionic bond? As we know that cesium bromide belongs to alkali metal, contain CS plus and Br minus. So these ions are combined by ionic bonding. Also barium bromide. Barium is alkaline earth metal. So barium plus 2 and 2 Br minus. It is also an ionic compound. And strontium is also alkaline earth metal and oxide form Sr2 plus and plus O2 minus. So in option A, cesium bromide, barium bromide and strontium oxide, all the compounds have only ionic bond. So question number 68. So question number 68 we have discussed first. Question number 68, option number A is correct. We have discussed question number 68 first. In all these compounds, only ionic bond is present. While in other options, compounds having covalent bonding like BF3, NH3, लाइक एसओ टू, लाइक एनसीएल थ्री, सीसीएल फोर. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 68, ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 67. एज क्वेश्चन नंबर 67 इज अबाउट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज लीस्ट लाइकली टू बिहेव एज लुईस स्पेस. एज वी नो दैट नाइट्रोजन फॉर्म थ्री बॉन्ड विद हाइड्रोजन एंड कंटेन वन लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज अवेलेबल फॉर डोनेशन, सो इट विल बिहेव एज लुईस स्पेस. सिमिलरली BF3, इन केस ऑफ BF3 द सेंट्रल एटम हैज इनकम्प्लीट ऑक्टेट. सेंट्रल एटम हैज इनकम्प्लीट ऑक्टेट, सो इट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशियंट. इफ इट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफिशियंट, सो इट विल बिहेव एज लुईस एसिड, नॉट लुईस बेस. सो इट विल नॉट बिहेव एज लुईस बेस. वाइल इन OH, ऑक्सीजन हैज लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, इट विल ऑल्सो बिहेव एज लुईस बेस, अवेलेबल फॉर डोनेशन. इन केस ऑफ वॉटर देर इज ऑल्सो लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेजेंट ऑन ऑक्सीजन एटम, इट कैन ऑल्सो बिहेव एज लुईस बेस. सो BF3 कैन बिहेव एज लुईस एसिड, नॉट लुईस बेस, बिकॉज सेंट्रल एटम हैज इनकम्प्लीट ऑक्टेट. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 67, ऑप्शन बी इज करेक्ट. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 69. एट क्वेश्चन नंबर 68 वी हैव डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 69. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 69 इज एन आयनिक कंपाउंड M+X- इज मोस्ट लाइकली टू फॉर्म फ्रॉम ए एंड बी. मोस्ट लाइकली टू फॉर्म फ्रॉम ए एंड बी. एज वी नो दैट फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ आयनिक कंपाउंड फेवरेबल कंडीशन इज लो आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी एंड हाई इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी. लो आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी ऑफ मेटल एंड हाई इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी ऑफ नॉन मेटल. सो मेटल शुड हैव लो आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी सो दैट इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू कैटायन. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 69, आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी ऑफ M इज लो. ऑप्शन नंबर B इज करेक्ट. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 70. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 70, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट फॉर्म कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड्स एज कंपेयर टू अदर एलिमेंट्स. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट फॉर्म प्रीडोमिनेंटली कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड एज कंपेयर टू अदर एलिमेंट्स विच कैन फॉर्म आयनिक कंपाउंड. एज वी नो दैट बेरिलियम, मैग्नीशियम, कैल्सियम एंड स्ट्रोंटियम. बेरिलियम हैज एनोमेलस बिहेवियर. Anomalous behavior means the chemical properties of beryllium is different from the rest element of the group. It is due to small size of beryllium atom and also high polarizing power. It has high polarizing power. And we know that covalent character is proportional to polarizing power. More polarizing power means more covalent character. Therefore, beryllium predominantly form covalent compounds. So, question number 70, option number C is correct. Now, question number 71. In question number 71, I4O9 is an. As we know that I4O9 exists in the form of IIO3 thrice. So IIO3 thrice exists in the form of I3 plus and 3IO3 minus. So I4O9 is basically an ionic compound because it exists in the form of ions I3 plus and IO3 minus ion. So question number 71, option A is correct. I4O9 is an ionic compound. Now question number 72. See, in question number 72, the correct statement for the molecule CSI3. CGM iodide. As we know, CGM is alkali metal. and CHM is alkali metal. It forms unipositive ion CS plus due to one valence electron in its outermost shell. So cesium iodide will break into CS plus. For neutrality of compound, charge must be balanced. So I3 will get minus 1 of charge. So it contains cesium plus and I3 minus 1 ion. So question number 72, option number B is correct. Now question number 73. Question number 73 is, which contain both polar and non-polar covalent bond. As we know that in H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, structure of H2O2 is open book-like structure. As the bond is formed between the same atom, oxygen, so it is non-polar bond. As both atoms have same electronegativity. While this bond is formed between different elements, different electronegativity, so this bond is polar bond. Hence, H2O2 will contain both types of bond. Polar covalent bond as well as non-polar covalent bond. So, question number 73, option B is correct. Now, question number 74 is about which among the following are non-polar molecules. As we know that polar molecules are those molecules which have non-zero dipole moment, while non-polar molecules have zero dipole moment, and symmetrical molecules have zero dipole moment. Symmetrical molecules are non-polar and have zero dipole moment. As shape of NCl3 is pyramidal. So we can say that SO3 has symmetrical shape, hence zero dipole moment. Also in case of PCl5, due to symmetrical structure, it also has zero dipole moment. So both PCl5 and SO3, both are symmetrical structure and both have zero dipole moment. Therefore, both are non-polar molecules. So question number 74, option 2, that is SO3 and PCl5, both are present in option number 4. So 74, option 4, option D is correct. Question number 75.